Hey everyone, I'm going to show how to get your character to move in first person in Unity 3D. In this project that I have open, I'm going to go to Package Manager, click Window, then Package Manager, and download the asset Polygon Prototype Pack from Cinti. I am only using this for the visuals of this tutorial and nothing more. You can use any character model you already own, or just find any free character model to use on the Unity Asset Store. Once you have your package imported into your project, you want to go where the character is and drag that character into the scene. I am just going to go into the demo scene of the package that I downloaded just to have something nice to look at. Once the character model is dragged into the scene, then I'm going to rename it to Player and give it a character controller. A character controller also gets seen as a collider, so make sure to delete any colliders that are already on the character model. With that done, I will go to the project view and add another folder in assets and call it scripts. The first script we will be creating will be called movement. Create the script and then attach it to your character game object in the scene. Before going into the code, we want to take the main camera that is already in the scene and drag it into the character game object so that the camera will follow the player. If you do not have a main camera in the scene, then you can always right-click the game object and create new main camera. Now we will open up the script and get our character moving. In the update method, we only want to adjust the X and the Z transform of the game object, which is the character. So we will make X a float and equal to input.getAxis horizontal. So when you press A or D or left and right arrows on the keyboard, then you will go left and right. And make Z a float and do the same as per X, but just the getAxis will be vertical for W and S and up and down arrows on the keyboard. Now that we have given values to X and Z variables, now we actually want to move the player. First, we want to go to the top of the script and make a public variable, which is of character controller, and call it controller. We then want to adjust the vector 3 of the character to the input that we receive. So we will create in the update method vector 3 and call it move, which will equal to transform.right times x variable and plus transform.forward times the z variable. Now that we have a vector 3 motion, we can use the controller variable we created. And the cool thing with character controller is that it has a move method, which you can use. So we will use controller.move, and in brackets we will use vector3 move we created. In the Unity inspector, make sure to take the player game object and assign it to the movement script for the character controller. So if I had to run the game now, then I am pretty sure the character is going to move super fast. The reason for this being is because it is using the frame rate of the computer instead of movement over time. So what we want to do in the code is to make a speed variable to adjust the movement speed of the character. We will go into the script and make a public float called speed. I will create a header at the top just so that I know what section this is in the inspector and call it values. Let us give ourselves the default speed of 10 float. And back to the controller.move, we now want to multiply move with speed and multiply with time.delta time. And if we play the game now, we will see that we are moving at a normal pace. Now while we are playing, the one thing that we would want is to look around. So back in the Unity inspector, we can create a new script called mouse look at and attach the script to the main camera. We want to rotate the x-axis of the camera for looking up and down and rotate the player for looking left and right. In the script, we want the following. We want to make sure that we get the value of where we are moving the mouse and then we want to make sure that the camera rotates accordingly with its X rotation. One extra thing is that we also want to make sure that you can only look upwards in a 90 degree angle and not be able to look behind you just by moving up. We define the first variable, which will be public transform player transform. Then we want to make the variable for mouse speed, which will be public float mouse speed, and the rotation, which is float x rotation, with the default value of 0 float. In the update method, we need input of the mouse. So we will create a float mouse x variable, which will get the input.getAccessMouseX and multiply the mouse speed as we said earlier. And also, as per the movement speed, we want it to not rely on frames per second, but on time. So we multiply with time.deltaTime, and then we create mouse Y and do the exact same as above. After we have input, we can move the player transform with the method rotate. So we will take player transform.rotate and use the vector3.up value and multiply with mouse X. This will determine moving left and right with the mouse. For the rotation of looking upwards, we will just give X rotation a value of minus equals mouse Y. And then make sure to clamp that value with X rotation equal mathf.clamp. We pass in X rotation and can't go past minus 90 float and can't go past 90 float. Once we have clamped the X rotation value, we can then make sure the game object transform.local rotation is equal to quaternion Euler angle, Euler, and then X rotation 0 float on the Y and 0 float on the Z. So the X rotation will, of course, be for X. Now, if we go back into Unity, we need to make sure the mouse speed is set the way we want and add the character game object to the player transform and then run the game to see if we can indeed now look around. Oops, let's just go back into the code and add in the start method that the cursor.lockState equals to cursor.lockMode.locked. This will lock the mouse cursor in the center of the screen while playing. Okay, now that we can actually run around and look around, one last thing that we would like to do is jumping. So for jumping, we are going to need a few things. We will need an empty game object on the player and just call it ground check. Then head back into movement script and add the bool of is grounded. That will check if you are on the ground or not. For this, we will use the physics system that will create a mini sphere at the game object location and use the distance we provide to make sure if we are indeed interacting with something. For this, we will need to define the layer mask, and we will create a public layer mask called ground mask, and also create a public transform called ground check for the game object we created a moment ago. Then we want to know how far the ground is by creating a float variable and call it ground distance with a default value of 0.4 float. In the update method, we are going to set the bool value of is grounded. So we are going to say is grounded is equal to physics.checksphere ground check, which is the game object, dot position, ground distance, ground mask. So pretty straightforward. The position of the game object will create a sphere, which is the ground distance, and check for collision of the ground mask. Now that we know that we are on the ground, now we want to get off the ground. For this, we will need a few more variables. It will be vector 3, and we will call it velocity, and then gravity to fall. So public float gravity, and we can just put this under header values, and the best value that I have tested so far is minus 9.8 float as default. Then we create a public float called jump height and give it the default value of 2 float. You can set it to 50 float if you really want to, but then you will be jumping like Yeah, you'll be jumping. Back in the update method, when you press the spacebar, we can say if input.get button down is jump and is grounded, then velocity.y for the y-axis is equal to mathf dot square root of jump height times minus 2f times gravity. And this will allow us to jump off the ground. So once we are in the air, we want to let gravity take over and let us go back down. So we will add after the input of the jump velocity dot y plus equals to gravity times time dot delta time. And also make sure the controller calls the move method with the new velocity times time dot delta time. But we also don't want velocity to continue going down endlessly. So if is grounded is true and velocity dot y is less than zero, then velocity dot y will equal minus one float. You can set this to zero and less or equal than zero in the if statement and test it out. But the best tested method was with minus one float. Now, if we go into Unity Inspector, we have to assign the variables that needs to be assigned. Also make sure that ground mask is assigned to a newly created layer, which can be done at the top right and add layer and just call it ground. And go back in the inspector. Then also the ground in the scene or any objects you can step on, make sure to change the layer mask to ground. One thing I have realized at the end is that your character game object, the character controller height, was below the floor, which pushed the character up. So make sure to edit the character controller. Now we can test and see if all looks and feels great. I can jump on things and gravity takes me down. This is a great first person controller to start off with, or you can just get the standard asset pack in Unity and use the FPS prefab that they have in the asset pack by just dragging and dropping it into the scene and playing the game. Subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you don't miss more videos helping you with game development in Unity. Make sure to check out the last video I posted about how I created the mobile game in 3 days. Thanks for watching. Cheers.